The problem is that 90% of the nutrients are gone within the first minute and a half that you blend. Number two, we should never, ever combine fruits and vegetables together or other combining that you have to learn about in food combining charts and through the history and science of food combination. Number three, if you take these foods and swallow them down after they're blended, you cannot digest them, and they ferment in the human body. When they ferment, you either become overweight or emaciated from taking blended foods. On the contrary, juicing is juicing. Why we drink juice is so that we don't have to struggle to digest the food. That you take green vegetables, not with fruits, but green vegetables that have the superior nutrition in it because it has captured the most nutrients on this planet from the sun itself in UV and UA rays. Sprouts being at the top of that list, organic green leafy vegetables that are fresh, and grasses. But you wouldn't mix grass into the juice. You would do that separately. You juice this down, and in 15 minutes, the people with the worst digestive tract on the planet Earth can digest those nutrients without any impairment, without any problem, without the mixing that we spoke about with blending. Plus that, if you let that come into the body rapidly, if you juice it and immediately consume it, you're going to get almost every nutrient. Now, if you let that juice sit for 15 minutes, again, it's null and void. Just like in a blender, in a minute and a half, most of the nutrients are gone. Why we brought wheatgrass back to the world? It is a major food that can be juiced. And this food has such high protein and such a full spectrum of nutrients in it that it helps to build healthy cells. And those healthy cells are what your anatomy is made of. Not only your organs, but every part of your structure, your bones, are made of cells. Now, when we have this high protein, nutrient-rich food, it has a secondary component that's even more outstanding and amazing, phytochemistry or phytonutrients. Now, these phytonutrients I write about in my series of books called Food is Medicine. And what we find is that these phytochemicals kill mutagens as well as microbes. Now, when we can fight off diseases like mutations and bacteria and viruses, along with building healthy cells, I can't think of anything more magnificent. And when I teach about wheatgrass, I teach it in a very simple way that anyone can understand, that all life on this planet comes from the sun. There are very few plants that capture the sun's energy from UV, UA rays, even closely to what grasses do. And wheatgrass has a full spectrum of 96 nutrients from the elemental table. There's 115. No food comes close to this. Wheatgrass has 96 of the 115 elements from that table. Now, when you find the sun rays captured by the grasses and converting into high protein, high vitamin, high mineral, high phytochemical, even essential fatty acids in a grass that you can now juice and anyone can digest, there's nothing better than this for you. So taking at least 2 ounces of wheatgrass a day, and ideally 2 ounces of wheatgrass twice a day, would make your health completely evolve to a much stronger level. And those of you fighting diseases, this is magnificent. This is what we've been using it for in great part here for 6 decades.